Also be using extractors, machine extractors, which are motorized to extract the fiber from the stem.
Millions of families feed on banana fruit every day across the country, and it's grown widely. At least 75% of farmers have matoke on their farms, and tons of the food crop is harvested every season. As one enjoys a meal of matoke, they are hardly thinking about its waste. Once banana is harvested, the stems are left to rot away in the gardens. But now innovators have found ways to get value out of banana waste, and youth are being taught how to do it in Bunyangabu and Kabarole. The skilling the youth in banana stem fiber extraction and fiber crafts making will run for 6 months. Mugara David is the head of governance and policy advocacy at Kabarole Resource and Research Center, which is behind the program. They are targeting especially those who dropped out of school.
Getting young people from Sokoto, Kabarole and Nyangabu. Specifically, these are the banana producing districts in all of Uganda.
They are working with youth groups located in the high banana production sub-counties, and 200 of them will be reached directly. Rabuhinga Richard, the Kabarole district chairperson, is challenging leaders to mobilize the youth to embrace the program.
They want to implore the youth representatives in the house to go out and mobilize the youth to benefit from this project.
Kabarole and Bunyangabu are the main banana production districts in the Rwenzori region, but with limited participation of youth in the banana value chain, discouraged by price fluctuations.
Because the young people look at these kind of jobs and enterprises as demeaning to them, because some of them have gone to universities, some of them have masters, so they believe that someone at that level of education cannot do such work.
Despite the challenges, leaders are urging continuous innovation. Success will mean banana farmers empowered in ways that will offer young women and men gainful employment in the banana value chain.